Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to SmackDown. Looks like we already got some action going underway. By the way, I am the United States Champion, Matt Eichhorn, and with me at the commentary table, filling in for the injured Frank Dog, is Carter.
Well, I tell you what, we're going ready to kick out the show. We got a fight going on in the middle of the ring.
Evan Bourne and Tyson Kidd are just going at it. I mean, we haven't even... I mean, this is a crazy way to start the show. I mean, these two are just... trying to destroy each other, and this is even
an official match, and the referee's not doing a damn thing about it.
I mean, they're not even. This isn't even an official match. I don't know what's going on. We need to get some order around here. And well, speaking of which, here comes the general manager.
Yeah, the guy who signs our paychecks.
Whoa! Wow!
Holy Toledo!
I mean, I don't usually agree with Bret Hart, but that's a great announcement to start off the show.
Well, I tell you what, Matt, that's a good way to set another set of what? Put those two in the steel cage match and just let them have at it.
I mean, SmackDown has barely started off, and we've already got a huge steel cage match announced for tonight, later tonight. Evan Bourne and Tyson Kidd are going to settle things in the 15-foot-high steel cage. No, I don't necessarily agree with Edge, but we're going to go ahead and move things along, and we're going to go to American Dragon Challenge. Daniel Bryan's coming out to the ring. I mean, do I really need to say how I feel about this guy?
No, I think your expression pretty much said it all.
I don't know who is going to come out here and embarrass this nerd, but we'll find out shortly.
Right now. Oh, man.
Are you serious? Holy shit.
I was about to say that Daniel Bryan has a chance to really improve himself. But I'm going to take my statement out the window now.
I mean, you're talking about one of the biggest and baddest men in the history of professional wrestling, Vader. And I think that Daniel Bryan is going to be rattled tonight.
You can say that again, man. I mean... Vader is this large behemoth. I mean, he can kick butt and he'll take names later.
I mean, I don't really see how Daniel Bryan could possibly survive this match, but I guess I gotta attempt to be unbiased in a way. But Vader, he's one of the biggest and baddest men on the planet, and this is gonna be a great match to watch.
Yeah, unless you're Daniel Bryan, you better make sure you make an appointment to go to the hospital by the time this match is over.
Look at the size of Vader. Look at the comparison in size. This is just going to be a monstrous contest. Mm-hmm. And I want to remind everybody that tonight, Santino Marella is not with Daniel Bryan. He is all alone tonight.
Which is bad news for Daniel Bryan.
You can see Vader immediately going to work, puts him into the turnbuckle, but...
Well, I tell you what, man, you look at Vader, I mean, we all remember Vader. Vader, you know, a former World Heavyweight Champion. In any league that he goes to, he's big, he's strong, he's the master of the powerbomb. I mean, he's very athletic in the ring.
I mean, the no matter how much experience Daniel Bryan has, no matter how good people think he is, it's going to take a lot for him to knock down Vader.
Well, you can pretty much say that again. I mean, remember that old Bible story, David versus Goliath?
I mean, you could say this is Daniel versus Goliath at this point.
Yeah,
just, look
Daniel,
at that. I mean, just the size of Vader, he wasn't even trying. He merely ran Daniel Bryan into the ground just by standing there.
Yeah, but Daniel's going to need more than just a slingshot. He's going to probably need like a shotgun.
He's trying to take Vader down with those kicks. He does have those educated feet, but... Oh, wait!
Oh, my goodness!
I mean, I'll say that was nice there, but there it is again. The strength and the size of Vader.
But I tell you what, man, like I said, Vader is this strong. Vader is this competitive. I don't like Daniel Bryan's chances of winning in this matchup.
Not to mention, you don't want to piss off Vader. I mean, that kick to the side of the head may have just made him even angrier.
Yeah.
Wants to prove a point here.
Yeah, now Daniel Bryan got the momentum. Well, he had the momentum. And then he lost it.
He lost it as quickly as he gained it with that big belly-to-belly suplex.
Mm-hmm. Vader. Oh, that was a mistake right there by Vader.
But you can see here, Daniel Bryan's trying to run into Vader and there's run through him, and it really isn't possible.
No, you're absolutely right.
You can't.
Vader is just so big.
You can see the strength of him just.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. Ooh, what a reversal by Daniel Bryan.
Rattling Vader here for a second.
And now Daniel Bryan. Ooh, okay, that's a good way of taking down a guy like Vader. Aim for the legs. Work on the legs a little bit.
You gotta work on the legs when you have a guy that's probably three times your size.
Yep.
And now Daniel Bryan continuing to go on it, but look at this! The counter sends him straight to the mat.
Yeah, and I tell you what, Vader is just having his way with Daniel Bryan right now.
I mean, it almost feels like he could end this at any moment. He's just having fun at the moment.
He's toying with Daniel Bryan, Matt. There's just no other way to put it.
You can see those hard right hands just send him all the way down. Something mm-hmm. that Daniel Bryan couldn't do with Vader.
Mm-mm. Vader. Oh.
Oh, man.
Man, that might be it. We got one. We got two. And no.
I mean, Daniel Bryan just using every little bit of energy he had to kick out of that huge splash.
I'll tell you what, man. I mean, Daniel Bryan trying to reverse it now. And now Daniel Bryan's got back in control.
Again, trying with those shin kicks. It's one of Daniel Bryan's specialties.
Mm-hmm. He needs to keep this up, though, man. I mean, he needs to stay fast. Because if you take your time with Vader, you are going to get your tail kick. Oh, world drop kick.
I mean, that's not something you usually see from a guy the size of Vader, but proving out all the stops. And you can hear these fans are in Daniel Bryan's corner, but that doesn't seem to help at all, because I don't think Vader cares what these fans think.
Nope. Ooh, man, what a shot to the gut.
And now you see Daniel Bryan is in trouble here tonight.
Yeah, I mean, man, Daniel Bryan needs to get back up and going, and I mean quickly.
Oh, and look at that, just ramming into the head, into his head, just pounding it into the skull.
Uh-oh. Oh, my goodness.
After tonight, I think Daniel Bryan might rethink his American Dragon Challenge when people like Vader are coming out to put the challenge.
What a splash. We got one, we got two, and we got... No!
Another near fall from Daniel Bryan. I don't know where this is coming from. Bryan has been taking a beating so far.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. You're absolutely right, man. I mean, Daniel Bryan is hanging in this matchup like a ring on a prayer.
Oh, and look at that huge electric chair drop.
Mm-hmm. But I think wait a minute. Now we got another pin. We got one. We got two. And a kick out by Daniel Bryan.
Another near fall here, but Vader's got to finish this up, because I think if you give Daniel Bryan the opportunity, he might just pull something out of his ass.
Uh-huh. Whoa! What insecurity! Uh-oh, Daniel Bryan now.
Daniel Bryan with those the vintage shin kicks.
Ooh.
One of three things he's good at.
Uh-oh, Daniel Bryan is climbing up to the top rope. Daniel Bryan waiting for Vader to get up. Vader turns around. Daniel Bryan. Oh, what a drop kick.
He's going to go for the cover here.
We got one. We got two. And a kick out by Vader.
I mean, Vader just, got some, Vader just simply overpowered Daniel Bryan with that one.
Uh-oh.
Here comes the Vader bomb.
Oh!
No!
Reversal by Daniel Bryan.
I think Daniel Bryan's starting to feel the energy of the crowd.
Oh, boy. Vader about to do something. Vader's about to lose momentum right here. Daniel Bryan with these kicks. And now Vader with the reversal. Ooh. Here comes Daniel Bryan. And oh, what an elbow by Daniel Bryan.
It's vintage Daniel Bryan. Here's the cover.
We got one. We got two. And a kick out by Vader. This thing is going, I tell you what, this thing is
going.
Oh,
here we go again, the Vader bomb attempt.
Oh, and another reversal by Daniel Bryan.
I will give Daniel Bryan one thing, and that is he has scouted the Vader bomb quite nicely, but other than that, he's really just been taking a beating.
Yeah. Ooh, wow.
Power slam.
When this match is over, son tells me Daniel Bryan is going to be eating his food through a straw. Amazing. Oh, we got one. We got two, and a kick out by Daniel Bryan.
I mean, this is going to teach Daniel Bryan that the boy should not play with the men. That's for sure.
You're absolutely right.
Again with those shin kicks.
And now Daniel Bryan. Oh, no. This could be it. No!
Third time. What the hell is going on here? What are you doing? Vader, you got to get out of this.
Vader is
get to the ropes!
Vader trying to drive to the ropes!
Vader, come on now! Get
your left on tight!
This man is one third your size. He cannot make you tap out. What are you doing here?
Trying to get to the ropes! And I don't think Vader is trying to get to the ropes, folks! And Vader has no choice but to tap out!
You gotta be kidding me. What the hell is going on here?
My goodness!
Have we stepped into the Twilight Zone? This doesn't make any sense.
My goodness, I tell you what, that was an awesome victory.
Daniel Bryan was literally beaten to a pulp the entire match and pulled that victory through the skin of his, through his teeth. I mean, that doesn't make any sense. How the hell does this happen?
I tell you what, this was indeed a huge upset by Daniel Bryan. Give Daniel Bryan credit, man. Daniel Bryan used his quickness to his advantage in this matchup.
You know, despite everything I have against Daniel Bryan, I will say this is his first real victory here in WEDF, and I can't take that away from him. But at the same time, how the hell does this even happen?
Anything can happen in WEDF, man. I hate to say it, but it's true. This is just an unbelievable victory for Daniel Bryan. Unbelievable.
I have no words. Wait a minute. Myself still doesn't believe that Rock has found himself a partner, but apparently after this contest between Rock and Swagger, we're going to find out who Rock is able to find out as a partner for that last resort tag team matchup.
I'll tell you what, man, this is going to be a very interesting, that's the $24,000 question. Who did Rock choose? And I tell you what, Jack Swagger better be careful, is he going to write? But this man's going to write a check, which his butt cannot cash.
You know, I got to be honest with you. I don't think The Rock has found anybody. I think that The Rock has been, you know, wasting his time talking trash. I don't think he found anybody. I think he's bluffing. And I think that
Dolph Ziggler is going to call his bluff and nobody's going to come out.
Yeah. Man, you know, The Rock is the kind of person that would let his actions go out.
Well, either way, we're going to see The Rock and Jack Swagger go one-on-one right here tonight. And this is a, kind of a little bit of a preview. The difference, though, is that at the moment, for Last Resort, we have a handicap match book. So if The Rock can't find himself a partner, he's going to be stuck doing a two-on-one contest. And we have seen that he doesn't fare well against these two men by himself.
Well, I tell you what, you're absolutely right, Matt. But no, it's great to have a partner in your corner. It's great to have a partner right there in your corner. But The Rock definitely needs to pick a partner. He is vulnerable, that is true, but he needs to pick a partner.
I mean, I think that in the back of his mind right now, he's thinking to himself, does he really have a partner? I think Slugger's going to take advantage of that. By the way, this is going to be a good one-on-one contest that we're going to see take place in just a moment.
Mm-hmm. We waiting on is the bell. And here we go, the action is underway, I'll tell you what.
I mean, Rock going right into Jack Swagger just immediately with those right hands.
I tell you what, Rock, you know, we're going to find out who his partner is going to be. And you got to give Rock credit. He's stepping up in this matchup right here.
I mean, this whole thing has been about the fact that, you know, Division One is just trying to prove that this is not, you know, this is not the same game The Rock has played all these years. This is about new competition and the new breed and the new class of competitors here, and it's about pure athletes.
But that's understandable, man. That is understandable and true. But you can't just up and insult a legend like The Rock, for crying out loud. I mean, obviously he proved that he still got something left in the tank.
I mean, you've seen the way that Division One has treated The Rock these last couple of weeks. I feel like they almost have earned the right to say what they want to say about him. I mean, the fact that Dolph Ziggler was able to come out and use the people's elbow and mock The Rock in his entrance, and The Rock couldn't do anything about it. You know, they kind of earned that right to do that.
Yeah, but it was too. Yeah, but remember, Ziggler lost to Rock at Lashing Back.
I think that I'm with Ziggler, and I say that Ziggler lost to Ziggler at Lashing Back. I still don't believe that The Rock had anything to do with that loss. I think that Ziggler got in his own way, and that's what happened in that contest, and things are going to change
Last
Resort.
Matt, I understand from where you're coming from. Don't get me wrong. I understand from where you're coming from, you know, but, I mean, this is The Rock that we're talking about. The Rock is a legend. The Rock is the icon. And I'm pretty sure that The Rock and whoever his partner is going to be will put Division One in their place.
I mean, I respect what you're saying. You know, he is a legend. He is this and that. I'd say he was a legend. I'd say that he's past his prime.
Wait a minute. Are you calling him a has-been?
I'm saying he is. That's exactly what I'm saying. I'm saying that Division One, who are not even at their prime yet, continue to get better, are going to put The Rock in his place come Last Resort.
Matt. It's an insult that you calling him a has-been. That's an insult.
I mean, the fact of the matter is, we got a lot of young competitors here in WEDF, and it's not just Division One. We're all trying to prove ourselves. We all want a piece of that spotlight, and The Rock just can't let that spotlight go. But tonight,
wait, let me get this straight. You mean to tell me that instead of listening to a wonderful veteran like The Rock, Division One gonna do whatever it takes to make sure he does the best in WEDF ever again? Is that what you're saying?
I mean, just think of what that would do for their career if those are the two guys that were able to take down The Rock, who people look so highly upon. Think of what that would do for their career, what that would do for their future. You know, the opportunities that would open up.
Yeah, but this is The Rock we're talking about, though. I mean, The Rock is the people's champion. And right now, I give Swagger credit. He is taking it to The Rock right now. I give Zagger credit for that.
Swagger, like I said, I mean, this is about proving that, you know, who the future of this company is. And Swagger right now is doing that against The Rock, you know. I mean, this could be proof that The Rock may not be ready for Last Resort, you know. If he can't take on Swagger one-on-one, how is he going to take on Division One as a whole?
Man, I'm sure whoever The Rock chooses as his partner, I'm sure that they will show Division One what they have to do to be the best in the business.
I guess we'll find out if that's true. Right now, you see their huge belly-to-belly suplex. He's showing off the technical prowess of Jack Swagger.
I tell you what, Jack Swagger is really, really, really doing some damage to the Rock right now. Whoa! I tell you what, we're about to see a sharpshooter.
Sharpshooter locked in by the Rock, and Swagger. Swagger is nowhere near the ropes. He's got to find a way to power out of that. And
Boy. That submission hold is locked on tight.
I mean, anything is possible here, though. Swagger now, I mean, he knows that the ropes aren't going to be the ticket out of it. And look at that.
My goodness.
People underestimate. Wait a minute. I think Swagger might be looking to hit a rock bottom.
Wait a minute, here comes, my goodness, what was us about the Rock?
Okay, he was going for the power bomb, but could not connect.
Rock down. And now, wait a minute, reverse by Swagger.
I mean, one of the things that people forget is that Jack Swagger is a lot bigger than you would think. He stands at about 6'5", 6'6", I believe. He's a pure athlete. He's a former two-time All-American, University of Oklahoma.
Maybe so, but look at the Rock going to town. Oh, what a DDT! Look at the Rock going to town on Jack Swagger.
Jack Swagger's in trouble here.
And a kick out.
Kick out by Swagger. This contest has been really down the middle for the when you think about the whole contest, but.
Oh, come on, man. That should have been a disqualification right there.
If the ref can't see it, and you got to do whatever it takes in order to get an advantage in the ring, that's what I say.
And now, right now, getting the momentum once again. And, Jack Swagger just reversed it. And the Rock. Oh, nice job right there. I tell you what, the Rock is doing a lot of damage so far in this matchup. Rock is coming right back in this thing.
I mean, you can't.
Oh, Springbuster!
I mean, this is just the vintage Rock. I mean, this.
Here comes the most electrifying move in all of entertainment, because here comes the People's Elbow.
I mean, he's good, but he's no Jack. He's no Dolph Ziggler.
Come on, man. I mean, good grief. Rock setting up for the Rock bottom.
Oh, but look at Swagger. Swagger counters him. And there's just another great amateur takedown. I mean, there's no way that the Rock is ever going to out-wrestle Jack Swagger. That's just the truth. Beautiful T-bone suplex.
Yeah, Swagger had momentum once again. And we got a pin. We got one. We got two. And a kick out. Tell you what, there is no quit in the Rock. Rock has a lot of heart. You gotta give him that.
You can have all the heart in the world, but it won't help you in the ring when a man like Jack Swagger is taking it to you. I mean,
yeah, you got a point.
And you can see here the confidence.
Jack Swagger. Jack Swagger chokes too much.
He's just showing the confidence in his ability, and look at this.
Ooh.
Beautiful power bomb. I think this.
He might be
thinking the swag bottom. No.
Bottom. On the rock bottom. We got here. We got one. We got two. And we got three. The match is over.
Well, you know what? I'll give Rock credit. He's able to beat Swagger 1-on-1. But as I've been saying this whole time, at last resort, it is Division One as a unit that The Rock must defeat. And at the moment, he's got nobody on his side. Whether or not he says he has a partner, I still don't believe him. So until I see it for myself, at the moment, it is a handicapped match that The Rock must face Division One in. And right now, and we have not seen him successfully taking both of them on his own.
But naturally, it's 2-on-1. I mean, you would like that type of action. You like to see one person take on two men and him getting his butt kicked in the middle of the ring. You like that type of action.
I mean, the truth of the matter is, if The Rock was as good as he said he was, he'd be taking them on his own and doing it with no problem. He'd be kicking ass just like people said he could. But no, he's gotta find himself a partner. He's gotta even up the odds, if you will.
If The Rock you don't like it when it's one on one. You don't like it when it's fair down the middle. You might prefer if a person cheats the victory.
Look, I have no problem with one on one competition, but I'm just saying that if The Rock has chosen to take these two guys on after the challenge was made to him. He knew what he was getting himself into. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back. Absolutely correct. Whoa, what? What a cheap shot from Zack Ryder.
You call it a cheap shot, I call it getting even.
Well, either way, that's far from over between those two. And we are coming back into action. This is, of course, the other member of Division 1, Dolph Ziggler, what I would consider the leader of the group, and he is going to take on the quote-unquote partner that The Rock has found for last resort. We'll see if he even has the pull tonight.
Man, understand this. Dolph Ziggler is this overrated SOB. He and Jack Swagger have no respect whatsoever. None. I mean, what they've been doing to The Rock is just inexcusable. And I hope that whoever The Rock picks as a partner, I hope he put Division 1 in that place. I hope they take Division 1 to the woodshed and just beat the living.
Whoa, what? You gotta be kidding me. Randy Orton is The Rock's partner?
Oh, I love this. I love it. I love it. I love it. This is brilliant. What an excellent choice by The Rock.
I mean, this is... Look, I'm not even a fan of The Rock, and I gotta say, this is huge. This is another third-generation superstar that we have teaming up with The Rock. And, you know, Division 1, I think, is finally gonna have some competition on their hands. But I wanna go back to what we made. Something we were talking about during the Swagger and Rock match. We were talking a little bit about how The Rock has been forced to find Randy Orton as a partner in order to take on Division 1. I want to go back to last season. A certain guy by the name of Matt Eichhorn was on Monday Night Raw, and he was taking on Armando Estrada. And he took on a whole legion of competition that wanted that Armando Estrada hired in order to bring Eichhorn down. And I want to tell you, I did everything by myself, and I took all of them down one by one. I didn't need help from Randy Orton. I didn't need help from the other third-generation superstar. It was me against everybody else, and I did it on my own. If The Rock was as good as he said he was, he would do it on his own.
So are you saying that you're better than The Rock? Because if you're saying that you're better than The Rock, then it's a joke.
I'm just saying that The Rock might be talking a little bit more than he should. Like, he should be talking less and walking more. He needs to prove it with his actions instead of talking trash and then being forced to find a partner.
Hey, babe.
And you can see here Dolph Ziggler now playing mind games with Randy Orton, but...
Well, I tell you what, Dolph Ziggler, you know, you gotta get Randy Orton quit. Randy Orton has taken Dolph Ziggler to school. I mean, someone has to take Division One to school. Someone has to put Division One in their place. And now Dolph Ziggler's trying to run like a chicken.
I mean, the fact of the matter is you can't argue with the accolades of Division One. I mentioned before that Jack Swagger is a former two-time All-American at the University of Oklahoma. Dolph Ziggler, an All-American in his own right. He wrestled at Kent State University. So
yes,
both of these
guys... I understand that. Both of these guys... I can understand it. And I can understand, you know, they have a lot of talent. They have a lot of potential. I'm not disputing that. I'm disputing their attitude because they have a major attitude problem.
I think that right now they deserve to have that attitude. You can see here Dolph Ziggler's doing work on him.
So you mean to tell me that two men can? So you mean to tell me that two men attacking a legend like The Rock is a good idea?
I'm saying if they can back it up with their actions, then nobody can tell them otherwise. That's what I'm trying to say. And so far, all their actions have backed it up.
Randy Orton, speaking of backing up, Randy Orton is just dominating so far on Dolph Ziggler. And, too soon.
Dolph Ziggler so far has been in control for most of this contest. Despite Randy Orton outsmarting him at the beginning of the contest when he tried to run away, Dolph Ziggler has continued to remain in control.
Wait a minute, running away? You the one that saw Dolph Ziggler try to run out of the ring, try to make sure that the Rock doesn't get a piece of him?
I'm talking about when this match started is what I'm talking about.
Meanwhile, what would happen if Dolph Ziggler wins? I do not want to fathom the answer to that question.
I mean, I have three words for you if Dolph Ziggler wins. World Heavyweight Championship. I believe that if this happens with Dolph Ziggler winning this, then Dolph Ziggler definitely should and will get a World Heavyweight Championship opportunity in the future.
Probably so. But if he could just change his attitude, that's the thing. His attitude, in my opinion, is the only thing that's holding him back. Oh my goodness.
Here, Dolph Ziggler just continues to impress everybody. And it doesn't matter what your attitude is, if you can win, you know, I'm the United States champion, and people have been talking about the things that I've been saying and doing ever since I won. But you know what?
I'm the United States
champion. I back it up with my actions. I don't give a shit what people tell me, what people say about the way that I do things. And I think that's
cheat?
The same way.
What you cheat?
I have not done a single thing. I have not cheated once since becoming the United States champion. Thank you very much.
But the thing is, my opinion is that you gotta get along with the fans, at least in my opinion. I mean, the fans look up to you like a role model.
Look, the fact of the matter is, the fans can say and do whatever they want, but it doesn't change who. What people do, you know, if people thrive on what the fans say and do, then I see that as a weakness because you're letting other people factor in what you do. I mean, you see here Dolph Ziggler just taking it to Randy Orton on that corner.
Oh my, you're absolutely right. Right now, Dolph Ziggler is having his way with Randy Orton.
You know what? He does that not because of what the fans think, but in spite of what they think.
Probably so. That may be true. And now, Dolph Ziggler now is just having his way with Randy Orton. And Orton with the reversal. We got a pin.
Huge Kurakurana.
One, we got two, and a kick out by Randy Orton. That was close.
So far in this contest, every time Randy Orton attempts to get some momentum, Dolph Ziggler just stops it right in his tracks, but...
Randy Orton is getting hot now. And a huge power slam by Randy Orton.
Vintage Randy Orton. And look at that. Look at how cocky he is.
Oh, man. I think Randy Orton, at least in my opinion, I mean, he deserves it because he's so good in the ring. I mean, I don't think he's cocky at all.
I mean, we'll see if he can. Oh, wait a minute. I think we know what's coming up here. The apex predator is stalking his prey.
Here comes the.
Ziggler with the counter.
We got two and a kick out.
Orton able to kick out just in the nick of time, but you saw there that huge counter of the RKO. Ziggler knows what he's doing in the ring. He's aware of his surroundings. And look at that kick.
I tell you what, the ending may be near.
It's only a matter of time before Dolph Ziggler closes this one.
Got one, we got two, and a kick out by Randy Orton.
Dolph Ziggler has been in control this whole time. It's going to take a lot out of the Apex Predator for him to pull out a victory here tonight. But Dolph Ziggler has just been on point.
And a huge backbreaker. Randy Orton, now I tell you what, Randy Orton is having his way with Dolph Ziggler. And now Dolph Ziggler with a reversal.
Huge belly-to-belly suplex. Look at that leg drop. I think we might be looking at the zigzag.
Good reversal by Randy Orton. Oh, the RKO! That might be it.
What the? Out of nowhere.
We got two, and we got three, and the match is over. Nice job by Randy Orton.
You know, I'll give Randy Orton credit, but that does not change the fact that Division One as a unit is still one of the most devastating forces here in WEDF. And even with Randy Orton on Rock's side, it's going to take a lot for them to defeat Division One at last resort.
I think they're aware of that, man, but I think Division One is going to school. Last resort, they are going to school.
Either way you put it, this was a great match, but I'll give Randy Orton credit on one thing. You see right there that Eric RKO came out of nowhere. It was one of the most dangerous maneuvers here at WEDF in professional wrestling, period.
Absolutely. And when Randy Orton hits you with the RKO, you can count the doomsday because you're going to be out like a light. We're going to find too many men kick out the RKO.
He can celebrate this victory tonight, but come last resort, he's got a huge play. Wait, look at this.
Jack Swagger! What the hell is he doing here?
He's Division One is in full force now.
See, this is what I'm talking about. 2-on-1. You applaud when Jack Swagger comes out of the blue and just attacks Randy Orton like this.
I applaud results, and right now they are getting the results that they want.
I mean, come on now. This is just uncalled for. What the hell is security? Someone need to get these punks out of the ring. I mean, right now.
I mean, this is.
Oh, The Rock!
You gotta be kidding me.
The Rock is evening the odds!
The Rock attacked Jack Swagger from behind.
You chilled when Jack Swagger come from behind. The odds are now even, and Division One is going to school.
I mean, this is just an all-out brawl between these four men.
And you can say that. You can say that again.
I mean, chaos has just ensued. And Jack Swagger. Uh-oh. I think he's in trouble right now.
Look out! RKO! I tell you what. I tell you what. This tag team. I tell you what. Rock. And Orton, they are going to take Division One to school at last resort.
Well, I mean, they look good right now, but do they really have the unity that Division One has? We'll find out when last resort hits us. I mean, can these two really get along long enough to prove their point?
I suppose we'll find out at last resort.
You know, this crowd is disrespecting Alberto Del Rio. I don't like it.
Uh-oh, hold on, folks.
Chavo. Whoa. Looks like... Just a matter of minutes, but we have two new matches for Last Resort. Alberto Del Rio accepts the challenge that Kurt Angle gave him last week, and now Chavo cashing in the TV Championship match that he won at Trip to the Truth is going to take on Sin Cara.
Well, I tell you what, man, it's going to be on. It's going to be on like dick bones. It is going to be on like white on white. It is going to be on.
I mean, things just continue to get even bigger. Right now, we have the Intercontinental Champion, Ocean Jax, coming to the ring. Not sure what he has to say. I mean, we honestly haven't seen him. We have not seen him compete since Lashing Back, if I remember correctly.
Man, anytime a person battles in a TLC match, like in a ladder match, like he battled with Zack Ryder, believe me, you'll be out for a while.
He did come out on top. He was the one that won the match, and he was still given time off, you know? Now, I mean, if it were me, I would have come out, fist bumping, ready to take on whoever wanted to challenge me, but, you know, that's just me. You know, I have no disrespect toward Ocean Jax. I'm a friend of his, so we'll see what he has to say tonight.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. That's the attitude I like to hear.
Go ahead. Another superstar that has an attitude problem. And I mean a big one.
All right. Maybe that's one too many nicknames for Ocean Jax, but either way, I do agree that, you know, whoever he faces, he's going to be the victor.
He might be in for the supplies.
And here we go. Here comes the general manager. We're going to find out just exactly who will challenge Ocean Jax at Last Resort for the Intercontinental Championship.
Well, something tells me we're about to find out the answer to that question.
By the way, what's with that goofy-looking suit that he's wearing? Does he really think he looks, like, professional in that thing?
Last time I checked, bosses wear suits, man. He is right behind you. Ooh. Who could it be?
What?
Oh, no!
Are you kidding me?
Kofi Kingston!
Kofi Kingston with a cheap shot on the Intercontinental Champion.
Cheap shot? I mean, come on there, man. Kofi Kingston came from... Kofi Kingston, but that wasn't a cheap shot. Ocean Jax is just paying attention.
Either way, Ocean Jax is going to defend the Intercontinental Championship against a former WEDF champion.
That is going to be a very interesting matchup at Night of Champions.
This might be the end of his reign, but, you know.
Yeah, so that's what happens when you eat too many words.
Well, either way, he's got till Night of Champions to prepare for that one. He's got Last Resort off.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, things are just... I mean, that's the third match for a pay-per-view we've seen announced tonight.
And the night's not over yet.
Here we go. This guy. Here's the guy I wanted. Yeah, here we go. The World Heavyweight Champion. And he's going to...
I mean, Danny Jackpot, you know... Don't get me wrong. He's a great wrestler. But he also has a major attitude problem. I mean, he underwent a drastic attitude change. Like, he doesn't even care for the fans anymore.
I mean, that attitude change is what helped get him the World Heavyweight Championship. And tonight, he's going to team up with, in my opinion, the one guy who really deserves to fight him for the World Heavyweight Championship against the two men who were kind of thrown into it, if you ask me. But I'll get into that in a little bit. I was curious as to see if these two guys will actually be able to get along. Here comes his tag team partner, CM Punk. Punk, who was successful, once again, I want to mention again, successful in defeating Edge and Lashing Back, and that's a major reason why he was put into this World Heavyweight Championship match. CM Punk has just been impressive over the last few months, and he really deserves to be one of the people, he deserves to have a chance at the World Heavyweight Championship. I just think that he should be the only one.
You think he should be the only one? Now, wait a minute. Now, CM Punk, don't get me wrong, CM Punk is very great. He's a great superstar. But like I said, he's just another one of these superstars. You know, he beating up guys like Hogan and Triple H. I mean, just doesn't care, doesn't have any respect. He took Austin to the limit at Tribute to the Truth. But my overall point, he just doesn't care about anyone in the locker room. I don't get it with these superstars in WEDF. Rather than respecting the people that put the brand on the map in the first place, they just go out and just disrespect them all together.
Well, you know, here's the thing. If this is coming from somebody who actually believes what you're talking about, you know, these guys that paved the way, you know, I don't have a problem with what they did. The problem is that when you get to a certain point, you've got to step aside and let the new people and, you know, really build on what you put up. I mean, you paved the way for people so that other people can then take that road. When you hog the glory like Hogan, like Hogan did, and like, you know, other people are trying to do, it really, like The Rock is doing, and even like what Edge is doing here, it really frustrates people that are trying to make a name for themselves. And just like this is another prime example of somebody who maybe should be thinking about retiring soon. Just somebody who should, you know, who shouldn't, I mean, necessarily, you know, I want to argue with him being in this match, but at the same time, you know, he did earn his right to be in the match. He has proved himself since then. So, Shawn Michaels, despite, you know, what I've been saying, he has really proven himself this whole journey. Again, the reason why I think that this whole match is taking place, you know, for the couple of people he beat, like, Brock, Sheamus, Brock Lesnar. But again, the whole reason why this Fatal 4-Way is taking place at Last Resort is because Bret Hart is a man of bias. He wants Daniel Bryan. He has admitted the night he announced himself as general manager that he wants Danny Jackpot to lose the World Heavyweight Championship. And as the leader of this brand, you've got to be unbiased, you've got to be down the middle, and most importantly, you have got to have the best interest of these fans and of the people in the PDF. And so if Danny Jackpot is the World Heavyweight Championship, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Is it in the fan's best interest if Danny Jackpot is the the World Heavyweight Champion right now? I mean, if you think it's in the fans' best interest, I don't think so.
I mean, Danny Jackpot has won every single title match since. I mean, he's won his matches. He has proved himself as World Heavyweight Champion. You know, if the man wins his matches, then how can you complain about him being the champion? He is doing nothing but proving himself as the champion. You know,
Matt, I can understand where Bret Hart is coming from. Bret Hart doesn't like Danny Jackpot's attitude. Bret Hart doesn't like it because he wants somebody who can represent WEDF and represent it with Brian. That's who Bret Hart wants. And I don't blame him not one bit if he seems a little bit biased that he don't want Danny Jackpot to be champion anymore.
You know who I would like to see lead SmackDown and with true integrity?
Who?
John Laurinaitis.
Oh, dear Neptune.
I mean, that is a man of leadership. That is a man who would walk into this company, walk into this brand, and truly give... I mean, he would be the one to give us CM Punk versus Danny Jackpot.
he would be a man. He would be a great leader.
I mean, come on now. I mean, I disagree with that wholeheartedly. Yeah, I mean, if we get John Laurinaitis in WEDF, that is going to be the end of WEDF, because John Laurinaitis is going to run the Fed right straight down to the ground.
Either way, I want to point out that right now CM Punk has been taking complete control against Shawn Michaels, and this is exactly what I was talking about. You know, Danny Jackpot tagged himself in. I mean, he's the World Heavyweight Champion. He can do what he wants. But right now, you can see here, he's continuing what CM Punk started.
But I tell you what, you know, you look, Shawn Michaels now has control of this matchup right now. I'm sure Shawn Michaels, you know, I still think he has some left in the tank.
You know, I will admit that, I think that I'm right about everything, because I am. But I will back down a little bit on what I've been saying lately about Shawn Michaels, because I mentioned before he has beaten really big names, really big men. You know, he's one of those guys that, despite his size, he has always been able to take down the giants of professional wrestling. And I think he might actually, you know, maybe he does deserve to be in this World Heavyweight Championship match. Maybe not. I honestly think that it should have been Shawn Michaels versus CM Punk for the number one contenders match spot. However, the man that had just been tagged in, Edge, you know, he didn't have to fight for his opportunity in this match. And I want to remind you, what did he do at Lashing Back? He lost to the man standing across from him, CM Punk.
And speaking of CM Punk in the ring right now, CM Punk, come on, let's take him out of the ring!
You can see here that, well, the ref is doing his job, he's doing the count. You know, CM Punk didn't break the rules in any way. He got out of the ring before the five count.
And now Danny Jackpot, I tell you what. Ooh, good move right there by Danny Jackpot. I know Danny Jackpot is his car legend and all, but it's his attitude. I mean, he turned his back on the fans. I mean, that just put my sinks. That I can understand from where Bret Hart's coming from, like I said. And I think it's gonna be a good matchup at Last Resort, this Fatal 4. I think it'll be a good matchup.
I mean, I'm not doubting that this will be a good match, but I'm just doubting the reasoning behind the match, and more importantly, one particular superstar in the match, which is Edge. You know, Edge earlier talked. You know, we saw him backstage. He did a little interview, and look at this, Edge. Trying to take out both of these men. I don't know, maybe biting off more than he can chew, but Edge mentioned that he has all these accolades that over the years that prove that he deserves a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship. You know, and I can't take those accolades away from him. He's definitely been some, you know, he's one of the most world champions here in WEDF than anybody else. All these things that he's done for himself. But, you know, I'm talking about here and now. I'm not talking about the past. The past is that about, you know, the past shouldn't be a gateway to the things that you do. It should be about what you just did. And what he did most recently was lose to CM Punk. So he should have been put to the back of the line and been told to...
Are you questioning Bret Hart's intelligence in this thing?
Well, I mean, the man did have a stroke.
Oh, dear Neptune. Dear God. I tell you what, I think all four of these men, I tell you what, this is a good choice by Bret Hart. This is a good decision by Bret Hart that he got all four of these men in that Fatal 4-Way at Last Resort. And the way how I see it, I think it's a good decision. I don't like Danny Jackpot's chances of winning at Last Resort, to be honest with you. And you know what? I hope that he loses.
Well, you know what? The way I see it, you can put three men in the ring, you can put 30 men in the ring. Danny Jackpot is the World Heavyweight Champion for a reason, and look at that! Like a battering ram over the top rope. I mean, this is why he's the World Heavyweight Champion. The man has proven himself as a fighter.
Okay, now you're kissing up to him.
Look, I don't have to kiss up to Danny Jackpot. I've known him for long enough that if I have a problem with him, I can say it. Because I once did have a problem with him. But you know what? Me and Danny are good friends. And it doesn't matter that we're good friends, because I know talent when I see it. And the World Heavyweight Champion, Danny Jackpot, is a talented wrestler. Whether
yes,
you agree
I know
or
he's
not.
Very talented. I mean, he has the skill. Otherwise, he wouldn't be winning all those championships everywhere he goes. I can understand that. I respect Danny, but it's his attitude that makes me sick.
Well, I mean, his attitude is
his attitude is justified by the fact that he wins.
And Danny Jackpot right now has control in this matchup.
It looked like Danny might have gone for a pinfall, but I think Punk denied the tag. The tag, and now Punk is tagging himself in.
Well, I tell you what, I don't like where this is going.
These two don't seem to want to get along. Don't want to seem to work together. It's sort of each man for himself. And wait a minute, Impaler DDT from Edge. I think Punk might be in trouble here.
Yeah, I think we might see it. No, wait a minute, that's a tag. Shawn Michaels comes in.
Shawn Michaels.
Shawn Michaels with the chops now. CM, I tell you what, this thing is going back and forth right now. CM Punk is throwing Shawn Michaels up against the ropes. And, good move by Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels getting fired up.
CM Punk is in trouble here.
Beautiful
teardrop suplex.
Yes, to the right.
Oh, but look at this. Danny eating his partner.
Come on, man. This is just uncalled for.
And you can see Danny looked to eat his partner, and he actually gave him the time, but Edge did not enter the ring.
Oh, my goodness. Come on, man. Get him out of the ring. And now Shawn with a huge slam.
Wait a minute, look!
Oh, man!
Perhaps thinking about that elbow, but no! Danny knocked him off, and now look at this! The teamwork of these two men again!
Come on, ref!
But more importantly, I want to point out again that Edge is staying in his corner, is not helping out his partner, Shawn Michaels.
Yeah, absolutely fine. And that's what worries me about this. Why isn't he helping him? I mean, does he really want Shawn Michaels hurt?
I mean, this is every man for himself. Oh, look at this. Danny once again tagging himself in.
This is a tag match.
Plus, we know how he's been in the past. I mean, he didn't, you know, he wasn't just given the name of the Ultimate Opportunist. He earned that title.
Yeah, that's pretty much certain.
Whoa, look at Danny.
We got one, we got two. Oh, Edge comes in with the save.
Edge came in, but I don't know if he came in time.
And now, Shawn Michaels now once again having momentum in this matchup. And now CM Punk is coming in this thing. Come on, man! But he lost all control in this one.
CM Punk just being a good tag team partner once again. And again, Edge doesn't do anything about it.
And that's what worries me. What is Edge up to? I mean, does he really want Shawn Michaels to be weak? So weak that Shawn Michaels might not be able to compete?
Shawn Michaels at the moment is one of the top guys that people have been talking about taking the World Heavyweight Championship away. I mean, this is why he won 4 World Heavyweight Championships here in WEDF. This is why he is the man who he is. He's the Ultimate Opportunist. He does everything, you know, he does everything, you know, with you know, he plans everything out. You know, he knows when to seize everything.
And yeah, right now CM Punk is having his way with Shawn Michaels.
Signature Bulldog, the knee into the Bulldog, and I think Shawn Michaels might be going to sleep sometime soon.
Yeah, sometimes the enemy may be near.
Oh wow, no, but a counter.
And now Shawn Michaels climbing up to the top.
Punk got out of the way, and Danny once again tags himself in.
Boy, you question about if Shawn and Edge can get along. I'm beginning to wonder if Danny and CM Punk can get along.
I mean, you might question that, but I mean, every time that one of them is in trouble, what happens? The other one comes in to help him out.
Mm-hmm. What is this? Anything you can do, I can do better?
I mean, if Danny Jackpot is the World Heavyweight Champion, he should be the one to look the best in this contest.
Yeah, that's up for debate. But now Shawn Michaels is having his way with Danny Jackpot. Danny Jackpot is battling right back in this thing.
Fury of right hands and chops.
And now, wait a minute.
Oh! There's a window of opportunity. Shawn Michaels could get the tag. He could get the tag. Wait!
Come in!
Edge!
What the
What did I say? Edge is leaving Shawn Michaels out to dry.
My goodness, come on. Oh, no.
Uh-oh, here we go. Here comes the high roller.
Oh, my goodness.
The high roller connects. And Danny Jackpot's going to get the victory. Here's the cover. One, two.
And a three in the
match. World Heavyweight Champion gets a huge victory going into the Fatal 4-Way at Last Resort.
He just turned his back on Shawn Michaels.
I mean, the crazy thing is Edge talked about this earlier. He talked about Shawn Michaels would backstab people in the past in that interview. But now, Edge is getting the taste of his own medicine.
Yeah, I think this is karma.
Wait a minute. CM Punk with the World Heavyweight Champion.
What a sleep! Oh my goodness!
CM Punk gets the last words on the World Heavyweight Champion.
I tell you what, like I said, I don't like Danny's chances of winning at Last Resort. I honestly
Wait, Edge, he's back! Edge is stalking CM Punk!
Look out! Spear!
Spear! Spear! Spear! And now Edge is the last man standing in the ring.
This is unbelievable. This is chaos is running supreme here.
This Fatal 4-Way situation is out of control.
My goodness. This is just unbelievable.
And wait a minute.
Shawn Michaels, sweet champion.
Edge. Shawn Michaels with the payback. And now Shawn Michaels, once again, proving that size is not a factor.
Well, I tell you what, Last Resort is going to be on between those four men. I can't believe what just happened.
I mean, Shawn Michaels, if this is what we see at Last Resort, he could be walking off with the World Heavyweight Championship.
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute, here we go. The World Heavyweight Champion. One kick KO!
Oh my goodness!
And ladies and gentlemen, this is proof right here that the World Heavyweight Champion always gets the last word.
Oh man, say that again. Unbelievable.
There it is.
Danny Jackpot being the World Heavyweight Champion. Will this happen at Last Resort? Only time will tell. And only time will tell.
We'll be right back. Event. At the beginning of this show, we saw Tyson Kidd and Evan Bourne just go at it, and our general manager announced that tonight we would see these two square off in the steel cage, and that is what we are about to see here tonight.
Well, I tell you what, man, I think Bret Hart made the right decision here. I mean, obviously, we had the show got started with Evan Bourne and Tyson Kidd just getting at each other, just beating each other up before the show even got started.
This is going to be a great contest because I think that these two men are two of the more talented in terms of the young competitive guys. But we might have to wonder, whoever wins this, they might be added to the Intercontinental Championship that has already been announced for United Champions.
Yeah, you can say that again, Matt. But that's so much at stake here in this matchup. And I mean, you're in a steel cage match like this, you could possibly end your career.
Now, I'll say one thing. I used to praise Evan Bourne a lot because I think that he's one of those guys
that, you know, he's definitely one of the young high flyers that is really impressive. But if he does win this match, you might have to question whether or not he deserves an Intercontinental Championship shot again, because he's already lost on several occasions against Oshie Jackson, just in general over the past few months. So I might be wondering that, you know, this is a chance for Tyson Kidd to prove himself.
Well, I'm pretty sure that both men have an opportunity to do so. And hey, if Evan Bourne does win, then I think absolutely that he should get at least another crack at beating Ulster Jacks.
Well, either way, this win will not come easy because there's no escape out of the ring. Right now, I mean, the only way to escape is to climb over this 15-foot-high steel cage. You can also win this match via pinfall or submission, but it's not gonna be easy because you're not gonna be able to, you know, if you're in trouble, you're not gonna be able to exit the ring for a moment or anything like that. I mean, this is simply going to be two hungry competitors fighting like caged animals.
Yeah, you can pretty much say that again, man. Because that steel cage, believe it or not, also can be used as a weapon, and what a dangerous weapon it is.
I mean, you're talking about one of the most dangerous environments in professional wrestling, and right now, I mean, you see right now that these two guys are pretty cool, going pretty back and forth. But right now, Tyson Kidd does have the upper hand at the moment.
Mm-hmm, I tell you what, look at this now. This thing is going back and forth. And right now, Tyson Kidd... Look out!
There it is.
Oh, my goodness.
First time in the night we've seen that used as a weapon.
I tell you what, Tyson Kidd needs to keep this up against Evan Bourne. He needs to keep this up. He needs to do something. Evan Bourne's getting to fight back in this thing.
Oh, wow. Evan Bourne looked like he was trying to go for an Irish whip of some sort. But he was just not moving as fast as he's used to.
Yeah. And now Evan Bourne now. Tell you what, these two men, they're gonna be hurting by the time this match is over. Well, we got pinned, folks. We got one and a two and a kick out.
I mean, it looks like Evan Bourne's already starting to feel starting to feel the effects of the steel cage. I mean, who knows what could have happened when he was thrown into the steel cage head first.
Yeah, because that steel is unforgiving. I don't care who you are. That steel is unforgiving. That steel can hurt you. It can hurt you in so many ways.
You see there, Tyson Kidd is working on the back and the neck of Evan Bourne. Which is actually a really good strategy when you come to think of it. You know, Evan Bourne is a high flyer. You know, if his midsection is injured, he's not going to move around nearly as quickly. He's not going to go for as many huge high-flying spots as he might consider. Unless he was 100%.
I'll tell you what, Evan
Bourne. Wait a minute, Evan Bourne!
Oh, boy.
Oh!
Good grief! My goodness!
Tyson Kidd slingshot it head first into the cage.
I tell you what, these two men, they're putting their careers on the line in a match like this.
I think you have to do that every time you get in the ring, especially with this kind of environment, because you have everything to prove when you're in a match like this. And if you end up losing this contest with wanting to prove so much, then you just put yourself that much farther behind, and you have that much more you have to prove the next time you get in the ring. So this is definitely a match where you have to put everything in the ring and put everything on the line.
Yeah, absolutely. Right now, oh, Tyson Kidd going for the baby. We got one, we got two, and a kick out. Right, Evan Bourne. Evan Bourne is in serious trouble. Good grief.
And Evan Bourne is not moving, and I think Tyson Kidd, there it is. He's gonna
Tyson Kidd is...
He's trying to climb his way out of this cage, and Evan Bourne is to his feet. He's got to hurry up and make it to the other side of the ring.
Yeah, he better.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
I think...
Oh, this is going to be a hard fall. This is going to be a hard fall.
Wow. The impact that Tyson Kidd's body made with the canvas.
Yeah, Evan Bourne is still hurt. My goodness, he got to be hurt all over.
I mean, it looked like he was actually thinking about going up top rope, but he quickly changed his mind when he thought about the ramifications. Wait a minute!
Ooh! Nice moonsault. And now Evan Bourne going for the pin. We got one. We got two! And a kick out by Tyson Kidd.
Nice standing moonsault by Evan Bourne, but Tyson Kidd quickly...
Uh-oh!
Oh!
Wait a minute!
the speed of Evan Bourne allowed him to roll himself into that cover.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Oh my goodness. I tell you what, this thing is just going back and forth right here. These two men, they're battling. They are battling. There's so much at stake in a match like this.
I mean, they really are trying to prove that they deserve to be in some sort of title hunt of some sort. I mean, the competition is now wide open. We've seen Kofi Kingston. It was been announced for the Intercontinental Championship match. So anything is possible with Bret Hart in charge. You know, you never know when your opportunity might come. And
another one. Ooh, good game.
I want to point out that Tyson Kidd especially has a lot to prove, because Tyson Kidd last week asked Bret Hart for a favor, because they do have ties with Tyson Kidd being the last graduate of the Dungeon. But Tyson Kidd was not given special treatment by Bret Hart, and so Tyson Kidd knows that he has to prove himself, not just to himself, but for Bret Hart and for everybody here in the WEDF universe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, like, you know, respect is not given, respect is earned. You want, title shots are not given either. Title shots are earned.
I mean, not unless your name is Edge.
But I digress. Here we go again.
I digress. I remain focused on the main event. Evan Bourne now. Wait a minute.
Oh, he's going back to get Tyson to taste his own medicine.
Oh. You know, both of these men have tasted the steel of the steel cage.
I tell you what, this thing is going back and forth. They're going to be hurting all over. They could be hurting all over in the morning.
I mean, the longer this contest goes on, the more they're putting their bodies in risk. And the shorter, I mean, with each throw into the steel cages, they're shortening their careers that much more. And
here we go again.
Again.
I tell you what, I've seen my fair share of steel cage matches. Steel cage matches are just downright brutal and just downright unforgivable.
I mean, wait a minute. Uh-oh, it looks like both men have decided...
Both men are climbing!
I think Tyson Kidd's going to try to race him to the top. I mean,
my goodness.
The first man to reach the top of the cage might be the person to win this one.
Wait a minute. Both men are up there at the top. Who's going to get that?
Wait, what the fuck?
What the hell?
Holy shit.
Oh, my goodness. I can't believe it. I think both of them might be out cold.
I mean, high risk, high reward is not just a saying. You saw here first. Both men from the very top of a 15-foot steel cage threw themselves at each other, and they both hit the canvas hard. And, I mean, look at this. They're back to their feet already.
I tell you what, both these men are hurting. And I tell you what, they are going to be hurting in the morning by the time this match is over. My goodness, Evan Bourne now. And now Tyson Kidd down the headlock. And Evan Bourne with the reversal. This thing is just going back and forth. These men, they gotta be hurting all over.
I mean, this whole thing is just out of control. I mean, I don't know where to call this one at the moment. I mean, wait a minute.
Tyson Kidd is busted wide open.
I mean, that knee of Evan Bourne's, I mean, you want to know how powerful it is. I mean, you see proof of it right there. Tyson Kidd has just been busted open by Evan Bourne's knee.
I tell you what, this is just brutal right here. This is barbaric.
I mean, what is it going to take for one of these men to come out of this as the winner? And for them to...
Oh, man. I tell you what, this is a new level of brutality. I don't care who you are. Oh! I mean, when your head keeps on getting hit to steel again and again and again... I mean, I don't care who you are not going to make it through the end of the match.
I mean, you got to wonder at this point, has Tyson Kidd done enough to put Evan Bourne away and to secure this victory?
If it's not, I feel sorry. Oh, no! I feel sorry what he has to do. And,
Well, how the fuck did he kick out?
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, at this point, Evan Bourne is going to be crazy to kick out after all of everything that he's just been
hit
into his wow.
And Evan Bourne is bleeding like a stuffed pig.
His forehead cut has busted open.
Uh-oh.
I think this might be it.
Yeah, something tells me the enemy may be near right here.
Oh, wait a minute. Here we go.
Oh, wait a minute. Will Evan Bourne tap out? Obviously. No.
Wait a minute. What just happened?
In that. Oh, no.
I think maybe Tyson Kidd didn't want to win that way.
No, I think he's doing a lot of damage right now. And
he might be,
Tyson Kidd.
He might be. Wait a minute. Here we go. Wait, is this?
Oh, my
beautiful
goodness.
Tiger
bomb. We got two and go!
Evan Bourne kicking out once again, but I think Tyson Kidd might be thinking he doesn't want to win this by making Evan Bourne tap out. This is a steel cage match. He wants to win this. The only true way you can win a steel cage match, and that's by escaping this cage and truly declaring himself the winner, but does he even have the energy to climb out of the cage?
I tell you what, I don't think neither of these men are going to be able to survive this matchup. I mean, this is just downright brutal.
Oh, and look at Evan Bourne. But Tyson Kidd.
Both their heads are ringing.
I mean, neither of these two men. Wait a minute. Now he goes for the cover.
We got two and a kick out by Evan Bourne.
Evan Bourne just continuing to kick out of everything.
What does Tyson Kidd have to do to keep Evan Bourne down?
I honestly don't know.
Because he's throwing everything at Evan Bourne but the kitchen sink.
I mean, I don't know what it's going to take at this point because for either of these men, honestly. But I mean, specifically, we've seen Evan Bourne taking all kinds of punishment. We saw him get busted open by the steel cage.
We got one, we got two, and a kick out by Tyson Kidd. Go ahead, what you were saying, man. I started to interrupt you.
No, I was just saying that both of these men have been taking a ton of punishment, and I don't know what's going to take. And wait a minute, Evan Bourne.
We're about to see a huge superplex coming. Oh, huge superplex.
I think Evan Bourne's telling the ref to open the cage door. He's going to try to crawl out the cage door. I mean, but look at this. They're moving. You can see the wear and tear of their bodies. Yeah. They can't move that fast. He's trying so hard to just crawl his way to the door, crawl himself out, declare himself the winner. But, oh, you see here.
Tyson Kidd said this ain't over yet.
Tyson Kidd said you're not going to win. If you're going to win, you're not going to win that way. And now just an old-fashioned wrestling amateur takedown.
I tell you what, I got to give both these men credit. I mean, both of them, they're lasting throughout this matchup. And that is just downright unbelievable to me because both men heads rammed to the steel cage again and again and again.
Wait a minute.
Oh! A
huge moonsault. He goes to the cover. I think this one's over now.
And no!
How? I mean, as somebody who has wrestled and, you know, as somebody who's been in the ring before, I just don't know. I mean, how are these guys continuing on after all of this?
Oh, my goodness. Honestly, they've been drinking a lot of Red Bull before this match took place.
I mean, these guys are just trying to. Oh, and look at this. He's going to try to. I think he's going to try to escape the cage again.
Tyson Kidd's trying to get out.
But I don't think he knows. He doesn't know, but. Evan Bourne pulls him.
And, oh, man. Nice moonsault right there by Evan Bourne. Evan Bourne now.
Wait a minute. Miami. Evan Bourne now. He's gonna escape the cage. Evan Bourne.
He's doing it.
Evan Bourne. Does he know that Tyson Kidd is on his feet? He's at the top of the cage. He can escape. Wait, what? Holy shit. What was he thinking?
Oh my goodness, Evan Bourne!
Shooting star, going airborne! Does he have it?
One, we got two, and we have a three, and the match is over!
I mean, what a finish! Evan Bourne! I thought he was going to skip the cage, I thought he was going to climb over the cage, hit the ground and call it a night, but I guess he decided that wasn't enough.
I tell you what, you gotta give Evan Bourne credit. Evan Bourne threw everything in this matchup. Both these men, they fought like as if there was no tomorrow. They didn't quit. There wasn't any quit in them.
I wanna go through the ending of this match again. Evan Bourne, cross body from the very top of the cage, and then
you see right here, immediately follows it off by going airborne with the shooting star press. And, I mean, what a victory here tonight for Evan Bourne.
Yeah, I'm going to say that again, man. I mean, I can't believe what we just saw. What a way to finish off SmackDown.
I mean, this was a great way to end our main event. Nobody would have expected this to be a main event or even a good main event, but Bret Hart, I guess, got it right for once. And for this is the way we're going to end off SmackDown for I'm the United States Champion, Matt Eichhorn.
And I am C-Pod. Thank you so much for tuning in, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you next time. Until then.